My name is Kathleen Ho. I go to Rutgers University in New Brunswick. My major when I was an undergrad was psychology, so I have a bachelor's in psychology now, and I'm actually going to the graduate program, the Graduate School of Education, and I'm trying to get my dual certification so I can teach special education, K through 12, as well as general ed, K through 5.
My name is Mariana Stevenson. I teach in Rutgers Preparatory School, and I teach Spanish and French. I've been teaching for 16 years, and in Rutgers Preparatory School, I've been here for the last 10 years.
I'm not really sure. Actually, I can't pinpoint a specific time when I wanted to be a teacher, but I do remember ever since I was a little kid, my brother can attest to this, I would make him play things like school with me, and I would be the teacher, and he would have to be the student. It was horrible because he's like, I already go to school, why do I have to play school at home with you? But I just found something great about, you know, teaching. So I would say it's always been something I've wanted to do ever since I was younger. I always wanted to be a teacher because I had a great teacher to inspire me, and I wanted to be just like that teacher. So I would say maybe if I had to put a time on it, third grade.
When me and Kathleen were little, we used to go downstairs in the kitchen table and pretend to be students at school. And she always made like small paper sheets like math or English just to solve it, just for fun. And I remember it used to be really fun because I would get like perfect on the score because she always helped me when reporting.
I've always loved learning, so I feel like it's something I never want to stop doing. And as a teacher, it's your job to not only help others learn, but you learn in the process as well. So I encourage that lifelong learner, and that's one of my philosophies on being a teacher, being a student. It's a very reciprocal relationship. So I wanted to be a teacher because I wanted to teach kids to love to learn as much as I do, and I wanted to help as many kids see that and just love to learn because it's something that's really great.
I think that I like, originally what I like was translation. Translate from English to Spanish, to be a bridge between cultures. When I had my own child, I started to enjoy teaching teaching three children. And from there you go, I just like teaching and the rewards that brings you.
Well, just like every college student coming into undergrad freshman year, I came in undecided, not really knowing what I wanted to do. I thought at some point, for some strange reason, I wanted to pursue a career in pharmacy, and I took all the classes and I realized, you know what, this is really not for me. It's not something I really wanted to do. So I went into psychology because I've always been interested in how people think, and more specifically child development. So how do children think? And then that stemmed me into, well, I've always wanted to be a teacher, so if I have a strong background in psychology and I understand how people and children develop, maybe that would help me in my teaching, or to pursue my teaching profession. So then I got into the grad school. My junior year I applied and I was accepted, so senior year started and I began working on my master's degree. So that's how I came a roundabout way to the teaching profession. I didn't really know that I wanted to get into special ed right away, but like I said, I had a stronger background in psychology, so that helped me understand some of the atypical development in children. Also, I had experience being that I have a younger brother who has special learning needs, and I had to work with him a little bit at home on his schoolwork. And I found that it was, you know, a different approach than how a normal functioning child would think. So I thought to myself, well, how do I help a child who can learn just like everyone else, but just in a different way? So once I got to education at Rutgers, I took an introduction to special education class, and I found it really interesting that, some of these children, they just can rise to your expectations, even when people don't think that they will. And I want to be that person that's there for them to get that push to believe in the kids who no one believes in.
Throughout the years, when I started from middle school to high school, I was always in disability classes. And not to be mean, but when you're in those classes, a lot of kids made fun of you. It's like, oh, he's in a small resource class. He's not like us, not smart like us. But since Kathleen was like in honor classes, I knew she was definitely the smartest one in the family. So I always came up to her when I was, you know, lost with school. And she gave me the confidence to go all the way. And then throughout sophomore year in high school, I got a disability classes and moved up to regular classes because of her.
My student teaching internship takes place at Central Elementary School. It's a newer elementary school from preschool up to fifth grade. And it's located in East Brunswick, New Jersey. What responsibilities I have? Pretty much everything that a normal teacher would do. When I hit first day of school, they said, welcome to school. You're now like a teacher, so do everything that we do. We're responsible for, of course, the safety and welfare of all the children, knowing where they are at all times. I'm responsible for lesson plans, teaching, getting up in front of the room teaching. Whatever duties my teacher has, I have to do it too. So I'm not excluded from any meetings. I go to all the training, all the workshops, and I am fully included in everything that the staff does. You bring home work with you, I would say, for me, every single day, but on average for a teacher, probably every other day at least, you always, always, always bring your work home. And even if it's not physical paperwork, you bring them home emotionally because your kids always stay with you and you never leave them at school, even when they leave you.
What advice would be not to prejudge a child thinking that you could read their personality or that they will be average? You need to actually wait until you know them well, and you'll be amazed of how different and how unique each child is, and the way they learn and the way they actually experience their own life is very different.
I guess I would have to say that what makes me smile the most would be working with that child and a child who doesn't learn as well as other kids, and helping them to realize that they are just the best at what they do. And when I leave for the day and I can make that child smile because he or she just was confident and they knew that, yes, I learned something today. That is the most rewarding thing, when that child with special learning needs can smile and they light up the room. Just the room radiates with their smile, and you feed off the energy and you can't help but smile yourself. And every day I get to leave with that feeling, and it's just the greatest feeling in the world.
The other advice I would give teachers is that sometimes it can be very discouraging, especially if you don't have the support from home, but you can do a lot if you count on that support from the parents. So, you know, not to get discouraged until you find the right way to do things.
My greatest accomplishment, I would say, is something that I helped one of my students to do. In order for you to understand this, you have to know a little bit about this student. He is actually the only student that I pull out for Resource Center, and he's just had so much to cope with about being the only one in the class, but that has that type of a learning need. But I've helped him to overcome that and to realize that he has potential in the subject of math specifically. He had taken a test on a geometry chapter, and I have to say that his retention of the material was solid. He knew his angles, he knew his triangles, and seeing him light up every day and sending him home every day with the feeling that I did great in math today and I learned it because of you is what I think would be my greatest accomplishment.
I believe that Kathleen will become a successful teacher because through all the years of my life asking her for help, and she always helped me with the biggest problem from math to English to reading, and I moved up in life as she helped me, and I progressed a lot in the past, and I know she'll definitely be the best teacher out there.